Hi, good morning. So this is the Kingmakers IAS Academy Good Morning Test, which consists of 10 questions of daily current affairs. So as always, this will be presented by me, Ramya SR, a faculty at the Kingmakers IAS Academy. So today we'll be looking at the Good Morning Test of your 24th of July 2019. Yes? Okay. So moving on to the first question of the day. It asks for the World Economic Outlook, right? It is published by which of the following organizations? So that is the question. The World Economic Outlook is published by your IMF, that is your International Monetary Fund. Yes, it has cut India's growth forecast of the 2019-20 to 7% from its earlier forecast in April, which was on 7.3, right? So the earlier forecast was 7.3, so now it has been cut to 7%. So that was in news. IMF's World Economic Outlook update has also cut India's growth forecast in 2021 to 7.2% from your previous estimate, which was 7.5%, right? So that's what it is in news, right? Next is a statement-based question demanding correct statements regarding your SAT, that is your Securities Appellate Tribunal. It is a statutory body established under the SEBI Act, that is your Securities and Exchange Board of India, Act of 1992. Yes, this is correct. It aims, so the aim and objective of this SAT is given. It aims to hear and dispose of appeals against the orders passed by the SEBI. So the first instance, the order would be passed by the SEBI, right? So the appeal would be taken up to the SAT, right? The statement is correct. So both the statements are correct. So option C is correct. The Securities Appellate Tribunal is a statutory body established under the provision of Section 15K of the SEBI Act of 1992 to hear and dispose of appeals against the orders which are passed by the SEBI or by an adjudicating officer under the Act, and to exercise the jurisdiction, powers and authority conferred on the tribunal by or under this Act or any other law for the time being in force. Right? So both the statements were correct and it covers the whole of India. Yes. Moving on to the third question, it is with reference to your Global Fund, again demanding correct statements. It aims to fight AIDS, tuberculosis as well as malaria. Yes, this statement is correct. It is an initiative of the World Bank. No, it is not an initiative of the World Bank, but rather of the WHO. Right? So only statement one is correct. The Global Fund to fight the AIDS, tuberculosis and malaria, or simply termed as the Global Fund, it's an international financing organization that aims to attract, leverage and invest additional resources to end the epidemics of HIV and AIDS, tuberculosis and malaria, and to support the attainment of your SDGs, right? All the 17 SDGs which related to your health and all those established by the United Nations. So the SDGs were established by your UN, right? Yes. This Global Fund was founded back in 2002. It is a partnership between your governments, the civil society, the private sector, and people affected by the diseases. So even they are included. The organization maintains its secretariat in Geneva, which is in Switzerland. The Global Fund was formed as an independent, non-profit organization under the Swiss law and hosted by your World Health Organization, that is your WHO, in January 2002. Yes. Next is with respect to your Thuluni festival, right? So it is celebrated in which of the following state of India? So your answer is Nagaland, right? That's option D. Yes, the Thuluni is an important festival of the Sumi tribes of Nagaland, who are the inhabitants of the Zonhebeto district, right? This festival is celebrated in the month of July generally on the 8th day, so 8th day of July, right? Every year. The word Thuluni comes from a special type of drink, that is your rice beer, which was given in a glass made up of bamboo or the three leaves of plantain. So that is the, you know, the article or the substance that the glass is made up of, and then it is a rice beer. So that is what is your Thuluni. Yes, it is also known as Ani, that stands for the season of bountiful yields. Prayers are being offered to the god of productivity. The god of productivity is known as Litsaba, who is said to be responsible for the safeguard of the crops. Right? This again is like kind of a like a harvest festival. Yes, not a harvest, but the prior harvest. Yes. With reference to the Kisan Vikas Patra, consider the following statements, which demands for correct statements. It is a small savings certificate scheme from the Indian Post Office. Yes, this is correct. Minimum investment is 1,000 and there is no upper limit for the investment. This is also correct. Any citizen above the age of 18 years can buy a Kisan Vikas Patra. This is also correct. So all the three statements are correct. That is your option D is correct. The Indian Post introduced the Kisan Vikas Patra as a small saving certificate scheme back in 1988. Its primary objective is to encourage a long-term financial discipline in the people. As per your 2014 amendment of the scheme, now the scheme's tenure would be 118 months, right? That is your 9 years and 10 months. The scheme has been increased. And the minimum investment is 1,000 rupees and there is no upper limit for the investment. Yes. Any citizen above the age of 18 can buy a Kisan Vikas Patra from the nearest post office. A trust is also eligible to invest in your Kisan Vikas Patra. Two adults can jointly buy the KVP, even business entities, right? But those are not eligible. So what are the business entities? Like a company or an institution, the NRIs or the Hindu undivided family, right? These are all persons. They are considered as legal persons. But then they are not eligible to invest in KVPs, right? Only the trusts in the joint adults, like two individuals or two or more individuals, can do it. Yes, the investment can be made in the denomination of 1,000, 5,000, 10,000 and 50,000. And there is no upper limit on the investment, as I already said. So the maturity period is of 100 months, right? The tenure is of 118, but the maturity period is 100 months. Yes. Consider the following statements regarding to your pencil portal. It's a separate online portal to ensure effective implementation of the National Child Labour Project Scheme, that is your NCLP scheme. This statement is correct, yes. It is launched by your Ministry of Women and Child Development, is that so? No, it is by your Labour Ministry, Union Labour Ministry. Right, so only statement one is correct and the question demands for correct statements. So your answer is option A. The Union Minister for the Labour informed the Lok Sabha that 361 complaints of child labour have been resolved through the Pencil Portal. The Pencil Portal, that is, it has a website, pencil.gov.in, has various components, namely child tracking system, complaint corner, state government, National Child Labour Project, which is your NCLP, and also convergence of all the above, right? Yes, the platform for effective enforcement for no child labour. So that is the expansion of the abbreviation PENCIL. This is to be noted. Yes, platform for effective enforcement for no child labour is a separate online portal to ensure effective enforcement of the provisions of your Child Labour Act as well as the smooth implementation of your NCLP. This is the aim and objective, or it is also the definition of your PENCIL portal. The portal connects the central government to all the state governments, your districts, the local bodies, the project societies, as well as the general public. Yes, so everyone is connected. Further, online complaints regarding child labour can also be filed by anybody on the PENCIL portal. The complaint gets assigned to the concerned nodal officer automatically by the system for further necessary action. Yes? Right. Moving on to the seventh question of the day. This again is with regard to your NCLP directly, right? Demanding for the correct statements. It is a central sector scheme, yes, for rehabilitation of child labour, yes. The scheme focuses only, so it's an extreme statement, on adolescent workers below the age of 18 years in the targeted area engaged in your hazardous occupation. No, this is wrong, right? It also has another targets, children, right? We'll look at that in the explanation. So your statement one only is correct. Yes, your NCLP is a central sector scheme for the rehabilitation of child labour. That part is correct. The central government has initiated this NCLP scheme to rehabilitate child labour in the country. And the scheme focuses on rehabilitation of children working in hazardous occupations and processes. Further, under the scheme, funds are provided directly to the district project society headed by your district magistrate or collector or deputy commissioner, who in turn will allocate these funds to the NGOs or the voluntary agencies for the running of the special training center. So it will focus upon all these three, right? All the child workers below the age of 14 years in the identified target area. The families of the child workers in the identified target area. And the next one is your adolescent workers below the age of 18 in the target area engaged in hazardous occupations or processes. This statement alone was given. So it not only focuses on these, but also the above too also, right? Yes. So the next question is with regard to your Baba Kavach. So that is in news. So what is it related to? The answer is it's a bulletproof jacket, right? Yes. India's lightest bulletproof jacket, the Baba Kavach, was launched back in the International Police Expo of 2019. The Baba Kavach was indigenously developed by the Ordnance Factory Board, that is your OFBs, and Mishra Dathu Nigam Limited, that is your Midani. Right, your OFB and your Midani together indigenously developed the lightest bulletproof jacket. It was displayed, yes. It's a state-of-the-art jacket that can withstand bullets fired from an AK-47 rifle as well as your INSAS, that is your Indian Small Arm System. It is a four-hard armor plates that would offer a 360 degree protection to the wearer from the front, back, as well as your either sides. Yes. With reference to your Rashtriya Ajivika Yojana, that's your mission, Rashtriya Ajivika mission, consider the following statements, right? Again, the question demands for correct statements. It's implemented by the Ministry of Rural Development, is that so? Yes. So the aims and objectives is given in the second statement. It aims to organize the rural poor women into a self-help group, that's your SHGs, and make them capable for self-employment. Is that so? That is also correct. So both 1 and 2 are correct. So your Rashtriya Ajivika mission is also known as Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana. That is your National Rural Livelihood Mission, right? Your day NRLM. It aims to organize the rural poor women into self-help groups and continuously nurturing and supporting them to take the economic activities so that they can come out of abject poverty. It's implemented by the Ministry of Rural Development. So there are also sub-schemes under your day NRLM, right? Rural Self-Employment Training Institutes, that is your RSETIs, right? Enables a trainee to take up a bank credit and start his or her own micro enterprise. Startup Village Entrepreneurship Program, that is your SVEPs, for facilitating the rural poor for setting up micro enterprises. So both of these are to set up your micro enterprises. Ajivika Grameen Express Yojana, that is your AGEY, to facilitate transport facilities in the rural areas, which also provides for self-employment opportunities to the rural poor. Yes, these are all the sub-schemes. So your 10th question, or the last question of the day, is with regard to your polity and governance, that is with regard to your Constitution of India. So which of the following are envisaged under the right against exploitation? So the right against exploitation would be your Articles 23 and 24. Prohibition of traffic in human beings and forced labor. Yes, that comes under that. Abolition of untouchability, that's Article 17, right? So that doesn't come under your right against exploitation. Protection of the interest of minorities is your Article 29, so that also doesn't come under your right against exploitation. Prohibition of employment of children in factories and mines, that is your hazardous occupations and processes. Yes, that is also, that is a part of right against exploitation. So 1 and 4 is the correct answer. Since the question demands for correct answer, your option C, 1 and 4 only, is your correct option. Yes. So that's what they have given. Article 17 is the abolition of untouchability, that's your right to equality. And Article 29, protection of interests of minorities, would come under your cultural and educational rights. Yes. So that's with regard to the 10 questions of today. Hope this again aids in your civil service preparation. Thank you and all the very best.